How to paint a spiral galaxy? Let's discuss. Hi, welcome back to my channel. This is Madhula, the artist behind Madhula Creations. And in today's video, we are going to do a spiral galaxy in acrylics. This is quite easy and simple, so do try this out. Let's get started. First, let's finish the background of the painting. So I'm taking a white canvas, but I wanted a very dark background to work for the galaxy. I am filling it with multiple colors. The colors that I am using here are ultramarine blue, Prussian blue. Along with that, I am also using a pinus gray to make it darker. To give more interest to the background, I am also using a crimson lake along with a white, which will give me a nice pink color. The purple color that you see around it is because it combines with the blues over there. So first let me brush it up and fill the entire canvas. Then I'm using a sponge to just dab it out. The underlying layer has to be completely dry before you work anything on top of it, otherwise you'll be pulling those colors. So once it is completely dry, let's start painting our galaxy on top of it. Actually, it's super easy to get fascinated by space. The stars are looking so splattered in the sky. So it is a perfect background setting for the painting. For doing a spiral galaxy, you will not require any sketch, but if you are very skeptical to do it directly with your brush, you can just mark your spiral outline with a white pencil. If not, go ahead to directly work with your brush. The only thing that you have to remember is you have to give nice spirals around the center bulging area. So your work will be to just do the spirals in an oval format. We are not going to do it like a circle. We are going to do it more in an oval way. If you are new to acrylics, download my free ebook Better Your Acrylics from the link book.modulacreations.com. It has 25 tips for beginners to improve your acrylic paintings and it's completely free. In the center, I'm using a combination of white and yellow. And around it, I'm using the colors Crimson Lake along with white. So I'm getting that pink color, which exactly matches with the color that I want. For the blues, I'm using an ultramarine blue and a cerulean blue. For the brighter blues, I'm using a turquoise blue. So it is just with blues and a Crimson Lake, you will be able to get the entire galaxy done. Spiral galaxy means they have twisted collection of stars and gases. So they form beautiful shapes. They get their name because of their shape of their disk. Most of these spiral galaxy has a central bulge, which is what we have shown with the white and the yellow there, and which is surrounded by a flat rotating disk of stars. So these stars is what we are showing it as a spiral. So after you got the initial spiral there, let's go ahead to do the stars. So we will not do the stars finally because that might go over whatever spiral galaxy that you have painted. So we have to do it somewhere in the middle. Go ahead to take your white paint along with a toothbrush or some brush which has a stiff edge, wherein you can splatter the white paint on the top of the background. Once that is done, you can go ahead to finish off your painting, wherein you will deepen the spiral by increasing the width and also the colors that you are using. Astronomers believe these are spirals because they are rotating around the central axis. These are actually caused due to density waves. Consider these waves as a water waves. So water waves, when we see it in a sea, they are quite flat and straight, right? But due to the rotation here in the galaxy, it makes the waves into spirals. So that is what we are trying to show. Our Milky Way is a spiral galaxy. It has a huge collection of stars, dust and gas, as you all know. So if we view the Milky Way from top or from the bottom, it will exactly have a look of the spinning pinwheel. So considering all of that fact, doing a spiral galaxy painting will be more fun and exciting. So when you are doing the spiral galaxy, just remember to have the lines or the spirals close to each other at the upper edge of our painting, that is between the center and the upper corner of the painting, and let the lower side have those spirals further apart from each other. Once you are happy with the spirals and once we are happy with the base layers that we have done, we are going to highlight few of these areas and also give the appearance of the gas there. So what to do for that? For highlighting, you can use the same combination of colors with a touch of white, wherein you go and highlight certain parts of each of these spirals. And for the gas alone, like how it has to expand its way out, you can show it with a dry brushing technique. So go ahead to take little bit of paint on a dry brush, blue or pink, wherever you wanted to show it, and slightly dab it along the spiral waves. That way you'll be able to show both the gas look as well as the highlighter effects on these spirals. There are a wide range of sizes for these spiral galaxies, so you need not worry about the number of spirals that you are doing. It can be less, it can be more. So don't worry about how many spirals you are doing, rather than just ensure that you are getting your spiral shapes correct. There are other types of galaxies like the lenticular, elliptical or the irregular galaxies. So you need not stick to the spiral galaxies as well. If you are interested in some other type of galaxy, go ahead and try that. You can keep the background as such. You can use the same method to create the same kind of a background. But on top of it, when you are working, instead of the spiral one, you can try few different galaxies as well. I am doing a spiral galaxy today, and this is because of the main reason that 2/3 of the galaxies that we are observing from here are mostly spiral galaxies. The final layers I am adding here are more brighter blues and pinks. So the center I have kept it more of a white. You can also keep it more of an yellow. I wanted it to be more bright, so I've just mixed a touch of yellow to it, but mostly kept it white. And apart from that, I've used mostly crimson lake along with white. So white I've mixed it more to show the highlighted area, which is just around the center bulge area. For the blues, I'm using a combination of ultramarine blue and cerulean blue, which gives me a nice middle color blue. I'm also using a touch of turquoise blue to get the brighter areas just in the center of the ring. So we are almost done. Here is the finished piece of the spiral galaxy. Hope you like this painting. If you have any doubts in doing this or in the process of making this, just put me a comment below. I'll be happy to answer all your queries. If you are looking out for similar acrylic painting tutorials, look out this playlist here, where you can see the materials, reviews of the products and much more. Do stay connected. I'll be posting video tutorials like this one, so do subscribe. See you in the next video. Happy painting. Bye-bye.